These three books I have, The Melanotropic Peptides, Volume 1, 2, and 3 by Mac E. Harley. These are volumes of books that were actually collected works all over the world that were finally sent to Mr. Hadley from the Department of Anatomy at the University of Arizona, Tucson, Arizona. Now there is a club of scientists that do nothing but do research on the melanin molecule. And if you're not in that club, then if you want to have access to the information, they will send it to you for a cost. These three volumes of books cost $608. This is what I invested my money in. Because, see, I understand that if I do not know who I am, then there's someone who does know who I am that can definitely alter my plans. So I have to know as much about myself as possible so that if there are any areas that I am sensitive to within myself, then I know what to do about that and to stay on guard so that that will always be a side of myself that I protect. Now, the question is, I think it's very interesting that obviously this is a calculated means of you not getting the information when they charge you $200 a volume. Okay, however, that is only a calculated means of you not getting the information if you truly believe that lack is a natural state of being. Because it is not. Abundance is the natural state of affairs on this planet. And so that means then that the Creator who made everything can supply you with whatever you need unlimitedly. And definitely when you have asked for information for you to be the best you can be, the Creator will deny you nothing. So then when we begin to, first of all, jump up and holler about what we can't afford as far as information, immediately is because you are locked into first, second, or third circuit. And not even the third, because people in third circuit will at least buy this information. So you are in second circuit, which is truly being the victim of this society, which means that you will never know mastery, and you will never have a high quality life because you are not willing to, first of all, know universal laws. That should be the first thing that is taught in all of our school systems, knowing that you can never, ever be enslaved. So then why do we sit and continuously send our kids to learn nonsense that eventually will be used against them, perhaps, to totally bring about their destruction? What good is a PhD when somebody can actually continuously beam a beam of light on you and drive you crazy? And do understand that that is a reality. Now, if you are activated to fifth circuit, you would know that somebody was doing that because your intuition would let you know, based on your environment, that something was not right and lead you to the source. Okay, but now, if nobody's ever taught you that you have seven circuits in the brain that you have to activate and teach you about your neuroanatomy and teach you how to eat and teach you truly how to learn to master each one of those circuits, yes, you will be destroyed and have spent 20, 25 years in school and nobody will ever know what happened to you. So true enough, a brain is a terrible thing to waste.
Yes,
and when we go up into these public schools as they are, we understand that they're wasting. So we have some of the greatest minds available. Why is it that our schools are not addressing that information? And it goes back again to the woman. And I have a real dedication to ensuring that as many women as possible begin to understand who they are. If you heard me on the radio show earlier today, in my sex workshops, I teach that the woman is a creatrix. She is the physical embodiment of the divine life force energy. The man is the creator, and he is the physical embodiment of the divine laws through which that life force energy is directed and formed. So if you understand what that means then that in this dimension, the feminine energy must always exist in everybody's life for them to continue to exist, because she is the emanation of the life force energy. Wherever she is not, there is no life. And you can walk into a structure where there's no women, and unless the brother has harnessed a tremendous amount of creative energy himself, you can immediately tell it. First of all, it's cold, it's barren, you can always tell that. And where she is, etc., the brother is always able to have unlimited power and creativity. So it's not coincidental that Europeans never ever assign a male in a leadership position that is not connected to a source of life. Now, you can check that out as to what's happening in South Africa and know where that's going. And don't ever let anybody insult you like that to do that. If somebody basically ego is such that they feel that they can't have a wife and they want to actually talk about leading you, then they are not the ones. Because they must have the life force energy to continuously have the energy to direct and create. Now, it becomes very interesting when we begin to actually look at women who don't want the life force energy. Now, that's awesome. Because when they are constantly chasing down means of birth control that they know nothing about, if you did the studies on normal plants, you would not want that in an animal, let alone shoved up your arm. When I was in training and in residency, it was an insult to give a human being Depo-Provera. We used that only for institutionalized women who were Down syndrome and profoundly mentally retarded, because we felt that it was better that if they were abused by any of the attendants, that pregnancy, et cetera, would be far more traumatic, and so therefore the end result of Depo-Provera was not near as dangerous as somebody who's profoundly retarded getting pregnant. Now, on the main magazine, the main African magazine, the pharmaceutical companies have full-page advertisements for you to come in and get your Depo-Provera like you're a stock animal once every 4 months. Now, if you are a thinking woman, you would immediately demand that that not ever be allowed to be flashed in your face as something that you're going to buy. Because they don't have that in Lear magazine. They don't have that in Mademoiselle. They don't have that in the Red Book. They don't have that in Young Mothers. I think that's interesting. And Ortho Novum has just as much money to advertise in there as they do in Essence and Ebony. So when you understand then and do the research to let you know that the scientists don't even think this is even worth giving to humans, Norplants were the first means of population birth control ever researched on African women. They went to Africa and researched this on 1 million African women before they brought it here. Because they understood that if they were going to make something distinctly for melanin dominant individuals, it had to be tested on them. So they took it there for that to happen. Now in these books, this is very interesting because all this is research on melanin by individuals all over the world that don't have any. All of the contributors come from Western Caucasian countries where they don't have any melanin, but they've dedicated all this time and money to doing research on something they don't have. It's very profound because here the last volume, volume 3, says mechanisms of action and biomedical applications. Now, one of the very interesting biomedical applications that they have is the capacity to take melanin-stimulating hormone and give it to random animals that have very little melanin, and it makes them black. Now, I thought that was awesome. But now they have elucidated that melanin-stimulating hormone, which is made in the pineal gland, there's many different types. There's an alpha, there's a delta, there's a lambda, and it's the alpha that is the most powerful. And it will take, as they say, a yellow rat, and once he is injected, turn him jet black permanently. So the little pheomelanin, okay, which deals from the yellow-orange range, etc., okay, now permanently becomes eumelanin. Now, see, you have to understand how awesome that is. Okay, because if you know anything about science and what's happening, see, that means now that if you're still stuck in second, third circuit, or even third circuit, there are going to be people that are going to be presented to you that you're not even going to understand what you're looking at. You're not even going to understand who's who because you do not understand what's actually happening with the capacity to manipulate tissue now. Okay, now you have to understand what is also so awesome is that because melanin is intelligent, it is always directly connected to neurons. Your skin is an external brain. That they recognize that they can take neuromelanin and tag it to a particular organ and then piggyback a substance on it, inject it into the body, and the melanin will not release that substance until it gets to that particular organ. Now, this is a new therapeutic treatment that they're going to now start delivering chemotherapeutic agents with. Now, where do you think they're getting all this melanin from?
Hey, seriously.
Now, that's very interesting. And I'll just let you do the research on that question.